clemency, there has been an increase over the past years in the terms of the number of elderly residents, and so some facilities have been rolled out together with BWOs. For instance, in the past few years, we've seen the establishment of a Lions Befrienders Senior Activity Centre at Block 420 in the Casa Clemency Zone. And that's been helpful in bringing vulnerable elderly together, especially from the two rental blocks in that zone. So I think moving forward, it's the same philosophy. You know, identifying elderly who are vulnerable, both financially as well as those who are potentially isolated, bringing them together and helping get younger volunteers on board as well to befriend them, build relationships. And that volunteering doesn't just help the recipient, it also transforms the volunteer internally, you know, that sense of doing something for the community. I've seen healthcare both through the lens of a practitioner and also as the relative of a patient. So you see both sides of that journey. And I would say that one of the things I hope to speak up for, if given the opportunity, is how we can try to better integrate hospital care as well as medical care in the community. How we can help residents and patients have better access to healthcare nearer their homes, and also helping the polyclinics and as well as the GPs continue to integrate better in the community. Because if you think about it, going back to the history of medicine, many, many years ago, you know, there was this idea of a doctor looking after a village. The doctor is part of the community, providing medical care, but also part of the community, understanding the community, engaging with the community. And I think we have an opportunity to build on that within the Jurong Clemency family and advocating more broadly as well.
My interest would be in the area of the statutes relating to this. There's the Family Justice Act, there is the Women's Charter, there's AMLA. So these are areas of interest that I'll be interested to look at. I think because from my course of work and from volunteer work, I see that, you know, the difficulties that they face can be, you know, compounded and make things very difficult for them to move on. It impacts on the children. So I think it's very important that there are proper policies as well as laws in place to help in these processes. Families are the building blocks of the community. I think it's important to pay attention to this. And youth being the next generation, it's important to actually also give a lot of focus in their development. So I think these are the areas that I'll be largely looking at.